2023 Ford Ranger. That's going to be announced tomorrow morning, so hopefully you're watching this tonight. Otherwise, some of this info might seem a little silly, but I think it's pretty relevant that we talk about the brand new Ford Ranger model coming out. It's pretty exciting. There's a lot of great points from what they're going to be doing to the factory, and actually it should be produced likely in two different factories, but we'll get to that in just a moment. So let's cover all the exciting upcoming information on the brand new Ford Ranger. Once again, thank you and welcome to Johnny's Car Care and Reviews. Hopefully you like this content, and if so, please hit that like button and subscribe. So let's talk 2023 Ford Ranger. Their live reveal is at 2 a.m. Well, that's because I guess it's the Ford Australia team that's running the show, and for them it's going to be 7 a.m. Here Eastern, it's going to be 2 a.m., so I doubt very many of us are still going to be up. So I'm going to share our early thoughts on this new exciting vehicle. This is a big deal for Ford because this is one of their biggest, best-selling global vehicles. You know, Rangers don't have, you know, they're not at an entry point in price. So this is a big deal for Ford. You can expect this thing to be pretty impressive. I think it'll take some cues in regards to, you know, the Mavericks. Flex bed, I'd put my money that we'll see a very usable Ford bed. I think it's going to take some cues from that. Now, we have been teased with some images, and it looks like the front grille is going to have much more of an F-150 look to it, the front grille and lights. I'm hoping the whole front end is a little more squared off than the current, you know, Ranger. I find the current Ranger has a bit of a, you know, kind of like a narrowing beak look to it. It's not the best description, but all I know is that I prefer the squared off look of the Maverick's front end and the F-150. Now, exciting news, especially for people in South Africa. It looks like there's very good chances that they're going to be getting about a $1.1 billion investment in their plant down there. And that's going to create 1,200 new jobs at the factory and 10,000 new jobs for the plant's supply chain. So that those 10,000 jobs for the supply chain, that's going to go all around the world. Few jobs everywhere, good news for everyone. It's not just robots doing the work. Also, that plant, they're going to be investing so much into it that it should be carbon neutral and energy self-sufficient by 2024. All part of plans, Ford's plan to do better by, you know, the planet and all of us. But let's get to the really exciting stuff. The really exciting stuff is motor, of course. I highly suspect they're still going to use the 2.3 liter, which sometimes you can never make people happy, because you're going to have the group of people, and sometimes it's the same people that will say, hey, new engine, I'm not touching that for at least 2-3 years until Gen 2, because you can never trust a new powertrain. And then you'll have other people that will say, hey, and sometimes it's the same people, they'll say, hey, that powertrain had problems when it was new, so I can't trust it. Even if you're on generation 2 or 3, we still sometimes hear it about the 3.5 liter twin turbo EcoBoost engine on the F-150 because of a few earlier on problems when they were first coming off the plant. And some people didn't trust it for years to come, even though it was, you know, years later and the product problem had been corrected. Well, you will get some naysayers on the 2.3 liter talking about gaskets or whatnot. The Focus RS, when it first came out with the 2.3 liter, I think there was a few problems. If I recall correctly, it was the gasket. That got all worked out. I'm finding the 2.3 liter to be a powerful and reliable power plant, making 350 horsepower and 350 pound-feet of torque in the Focus RS. In the Mustang, if I recall correctly, it's about 320 horsepower, 350 pound-feet of torque in the latest generation of the 2.3 liter in the Mustang. And I'm thinking we're going to get a bump in power for the new Ranger. You know, I think we're probably going to see, I'm hoping we're going to see tomorrow that they're going to announce the horsepower figures for the 2.3 liter at 300 horsepower and maybe 320 pound-feet of torque. Of course, I'm expecting it to still pull 7,000 pounds, and I'd be surprised but really pleased if they squeeze an extra 1,000 pounds out of it. But I'm not expecting the Ranger to get anywhere near the 10,000 pound towing capacity. I do expect the bed to be more of a flex bed, more usable, easier to use, and get a whole lot more feet out of the beds. So let's say they still give us a 5-foot bed. think we'll be able to use probably easily an extra 2-3 feet, so we can get it up to 8 feet. I'm expecting that we'll find out that that tailgate can be put at a 45 degree angle, so you can just, you know, have stuff stick out the back end. I'd be surprised if they didn't incorporate some of the Maverick's special tricks. Now, speaking of reliability of that 2.3 liter, the Ranger has been getting torture tested. Actually, the torture testing numbers I have here, it's really impressive. And by the way, they're changing the whole frame, so it's not gonna be the T6 frame anymore, like what's being used on the Bronco at the moment. Very, very strong frame, and I can expect it to continue to be a frame that's boxed in with, you know, boxed in means there's currently 7 transversal bars on the big tube frames, and those transversal bars pass through the main frame and they're welded on each side. So it makes for a very stiff, strong, long-lasting frame. I think that we'll continue to be very impressed by the frame, and they've been testing this and torture testing it also in off-road conditions. So I'm expecting the new Ranger to be even better at off-road, and part of it being better in off-road is I'm hoping that they're gonna announce a plug-in version tomorrow, and maybe not give us the stats, but if they are, we could see as high as 500 pound-feet of torque. If you think about the 3-liter twin-turbo six-cylinder in the Aviator, well, it's making an extra just about 200 pound-feet of torque more than what it does in, let's say, the Explorer ST. So I think we'll probably see about an extra 100-150 horsepower. Actually, plug-in, probably somewhere, maybe not quite as much on the horsepower, maybe 50 to 100 extra horsepower when it's plug-in, but definitely a whole lot more torque, which is going to be fantastic for off-roading. But we'll check in tomorrow and see if I was how right or how wrong I was on that. Put my reputation on the line here. No big deal. I'm not stressed at all about it, but the vehicle has been getting torture tested quite a bit. This is a very important product for Ford, so I'm expecting the reliability to be actually quite impressive. Now, that engine, I'm hoping they're not just going to reserve it for the Raptor Ranger. It would kind of make sense. The Raptors, you're always paying more for a whole lot more power. But I really hope that it can just be a nice, you know, somewhat, I'm okay with it being somewhat expensive option to have a plug-in 2.3 liter with all that torque. Or maybe there'll be a model that is plug-in. You can choose the that engine option for certain models other than the Raptor. Maybe it'll produce a little less torque, you know, maybe 390 or 400 pound-feet of torque, but then really kick it up in the Raptor Raptor model. At least I think that's how I do it, because I think it's great if we can offer plug-in to as many people as possible. Now, and do recall that the Raptor is an extreme off-roader, and all that extra torque on low end that the electric motor will provide would be just perfect for off-roading. Now, we talked about the plant, the Silverton plant in South Africa getting a whole bunch of Renaults to handle the new Ranger platform. I do expect, and I certainly do hope, that Michigan will continue to be making the Ranger, because they've done a fantastic job in the past for the Ranger, and I'm very pleased and I'm absolutely loving my Bronco. Do remember that the quality should be pretty great. Ford also has partnered with Volkswagen, and remember that the Volkswagen is going to be having their Amarok truck, so they'll be working on that together, the new Amarok and the Ford Ranger, coming out of the same South African plant. Now in Michigan, I'm pretty sure they're just gonna be sticking to Broncos and Raptors. I don't think we'll see any Volkswagens coming out of the plant in Michigan, but hey, who knows? I could be wrong on that. But this vehicle is being torture tested for extreme cold, extreme heat, desert driving, and also really horrible washboard styled roads. You know, roads that essentially just completely shake the truck apart. So, you know, like roads in Africa, or to a lesser extent, like roads in my area, they're bad, but they're not quite as bad as being out in the wilderness, but they are pretty washboard, and we do come across quite a few, you know, 4 to 10 inch deep holes, unfortunately, depending whether you're on the main roads or you're on the dirt road. So that covers the new Ranger intel. We'll have more tomorrow, and I will get back to all of you about the final details. I look forward to sharing the photos. So if you've liked this information, if you're interested in, you know, Ford products and reviews of mostly Fords, but whatever I can really get my hands on that interests me, please do like and subscribe. Helps feed that poodle, dress that poodle, and it definitely helps the channel out, bringing more content to the channel. Thank you so much. Have a great night, and thank you very much for joining me this evening. Take care.